Hello guys, my name is Ashley and I'm doing another video on electric fours, and this one is going to be about whether you should go to weekend one or you should go to weekend two. So if you want help making a decision about which weekend is better for you, then just keep on watching. If you don't know much about electric fours and want to know some tips and advice on how to be smart to survive the festival completely successfully, then you can check out my other video called something like Electric Fours Tips and Advice Survival Guide, something, I don't know. I'll put it in one of the cards right here. I also made a video last year about the improvements between Electric Fours 2015 and Electric Fours 2016. That will also be linked somewhere on the screen or down in the description, so if you haven't seen that, you can go check that out. Without further ado, let's get on into the video. So first, to decide obviously what weekend you want to go, you're going to be basing off the lineup. The 2018 lineup hasn't come out yet, so I'm going to be basing this decision off of factors other than the lineup. The lineups will be pretty similar. A lot of the lineups from weekend one and weekend two overlap, but there are some subtle changes, and those could play a big factor in deciding which weekend you want to go. One of the biggest differences between weekend one and weekend two was that I heard that a lot of more Electric Fours veterans went to weekend one. New people to Electric Fours went to weekend two. And I heard great things about the people at both weekends, but I just think that the veterans maybe wanted to be the first ones to know like what the festival would be like this year. You want all the new surprises because you've already been in the whole festival as a surprise to you, so you want to be the first ones to see all the changes. So Electric Fours weekend one in 2017 completely sold out, while weekend two did not sell out. So there's pros and cons to both of these. But I would say for me, the biggest pro to having more people weekend one is more totems. And obviously there's going to be less totems when there's less people at a certain weekend. And I think that the totems are a huge part of Electric Fours culture and adds a lot of personality to the festival. And you kind of feel like you get to know the people walking around and just the general crowd just by feeling out like the different artwork that they put together, and it normally makes everything really interesting. Some people get mad about it blocking the stage, but I think it adds an interesting effect to like the landscape of seeing the stage, and I think it's really fun. That is definitely a pro to more people and veterans at weekend one, because it is part of the Electric Fours culture. Veterans are going to come prepared with their totem. If they don't typically bring one to a festival, now they know, like, they want to bring one and be a part of it. That might also be why there was less on weekend two. All the newer people going weekend two. Obviously, not only new people went second weekend, and only people that have been to Electric Fours before went the first weekend. That's very generally speaking. A pro to going the second weekend when there are less people is you're gonna get a better spot for camping. You're obviously, there's probably gonna be no one out in Blueberry, which is the farthest camping ground and the biggest one. There's probably going to be a lot more room for you to dance and have fun at each of the stages. So that is a huge pro to going to the less crowded weekend. Something that a lot of people were scared of was the cleanliness of the festival going the second weekend. And I heard online that there wasn't too much of a difference, that the staff did an amazing job of cleaning up in the 4 days between each weekend. There is, will be the issue that, like last year, it rained both weekends, so it could rain the weekend before the first festival, but there aren't a bunch of people walking through the mud and kind of digging it up and creating like these huge mounds of mud that are like impossible to walk through. And that might be left over for the second weekend. So I'm kind of assuming that happened. It might have dried up a little bit, because it did dry up more from the first day when it rained to the last day. But I don't know, the mud was still definitely a big issue. I was wearing Vans that I can't tie, and with every step my shoes were coming off. Saw a lot of shoes lost in the mud. So obviously the weather is gonna be different next year, so that shouldn't be too much of a deciding factor for you, but it is something to think about. I think the biggest difference between weekend one and weekend two for me, as someone who was super excited about the legendary string cheese set on Saturday night before Bass Nectar, it was just super disappointing to see that they did not have all the special effects and they didn't have the 3-hour long string cheese set on Saturday for the first weekend. The second weekend, I don't know if I mentioned this, but I went the first weekend. I didn't go the second weekend. The second weekend did have the crazy string cheese set with 2 of the years I went, they had all these crazy balls flying around and hot air balloons and huge unicorn balloons. It was amazing and so fun and really gets you excited for what a lot of people is about to be the craziest set and that they're looking forward to the most. Is Base Nectar set. Because Base Nectar is a resident, there are a lot of people who come to Electric Forest knowing that Base Nectar is going to be there because they can count on their favorite artists being there. And I've just really grown to love Saturday night and the chill vibes, being able to relax and vibe out with all your friends right before the best set of the weekend. So super sad that that was not a part of weekend one. So just some general updates between 2017 and 2016. So one of the biggest things, I know this is like, I don't know, it's kind of too much information, but it's also really necessary to know, there were a lot more flushable bathrooms and toilets than last year. Last year was the first time I had seen any actual toilets in the venue, and they were just by Ranch Arena. But this year they added 2 more sets of them kind of in the back of the venue area near Shorewood Court. So that was a huge improvement. You had a lot more opportunities to use a regular bathroom, and there was always toilet paper in all of them, which was not the case in 2016. So they continued with a lot of secret sets as they always do, so that is nothing to worry about. They are here to stay. I actually saw my first secret set on Sunday night. I saw Minnesota and 12th Planet at this huge school bus RV. I kind of think Electric Forest planted it there. I don't think people actually took this school bus, but it was just a massive like stage. And I'm sure that they did sets there all weekend. So if you want to find the secret sets, that might be a little clue. Look for an RV that looks a little different than the rest, and probably where the secret sets are gonna be for the general admission camping. There was a ton more service for me. I have Verizon, and I think all my friends agreed that the service is a lot better this year than in the previous years. Obviously, you don't wanna be on your phone the whole time, but just as a way to get in contact with your friends, like, hey, I'm at Ranch Arena and I'm by this totem, and it was a lot easier to get into contact. I wasn't getting the texts all day, but there were times where all of them would flood in and I would be able to eventually figure out where my friends were if we got separated and we could all meet back up for the end of the night. Finally, there was an additional exit at the Blueberry Field camping area, which I don't think was there before. I've never camped in Blueberry, so I'm not 100% sure, but I don't think that this was an option before. It provided 2 exits at 2 opposite ends of the festival, which made getting out a lot easier. Last year, I got out in 5 hours because I left at like 9 or 10 by accident. We slept in. We did the same thing again this year and got out in like 45 minutes. That was amazing. It was a lot quicker to get in and to get out because of that. So that is it for my Electric Forest video about whether you should choose weekend one or you should choose weekend two. I'm super excited to see the lineup announcements. That will give us a lot more insight on which weekend we would want to go to, but with that factor eliminated, this is how you can choose. Like I said, I have 2 other videos about Electric Forest up on my channel, so you can click those. If any of you came up to me and I got to meet you guys at Electric Forest last year, that was super amazing. I was so excited that there was a couple people that recognized me. That's the first time I ever got recognized for anything on the internet. And I'm super awkward, so I'm sorry if you came up to me and I was like, how do you know me? Because I'm so excited. That's just never happened to me before. So if I see you at Electric Forest, be sure to come say hi. That is super awesome. I love to make new friends, obviously. If you want to see any more festival related videos, I am going to be trying to upload a lot more festival related videos and videos about concert and rave experiences. Up next, I am going to Base Nectar in Atlanta for New Year's Eve. I'm flying from Boston all the way down to Atlanta to spend New Year's Eve with our boy Lauren. So if I see you there, definitely come up and say hi. I will hopefully be uploading a video from that experience as well. Just subscribe and I will see you in the next video. Bye.